The next component to build for the shoe bench are these cross legs, and to do this, I opted for one of my least favorite joinery techniques, the half lap. As far as I'm concerned, half lap joinery is already complicated enough. By adding an angle to it is just asking for trouble. So in hindsight, there are far more accurate ways to achieve repeatable results for this joinery, but for this project, we set our miter gauge to the correct angle, draw reference lines in the throat plate to define the outer cutting edges of the stacked dado, and because my preferred method with any half lap is to first cut both shoulders to establish the width, I start by matching the layout lines in the leg stock with the reference lines in the throat plate. Once I'm satisfied with these initial passes, I'll then start nibbling away at the rest of the remaining material. Now before moving on to the next leg, I need to check the fit, and in this situation, it's still just a pinch too tight, so it's back over to the dado stack for a very careful extra pass to widen the gap. Once the fit is good, I simply repeat the process on the mating piece. So the next step is to raise the stack to the final height. Then, it's time to repeat the process all over again, including sneaking up on that matching existing shoulder. And did I mention that there's more accurate and easily repeatable ways to achieve this? Maybe I'll do that next time. But, you know, even while attempting to sneak up on the final cut, there's still just a little bit of play in this joint, but you know what? It's more than acceptable. And when placing the matching pair on top of each other, well, they're dead on. I deliberately left these leg blanks a little long with the intention of cutting them to the final length after the half lap was glued and assembled. So I set up my miter gauge to match the desired angle on the feet, and to help minimize any blowout from the cut, I even added sacrificial material to the back of each leg. After the first cut, I moved the rib fence over to the desired length, butt the legs up against them, clamp more sacrificial material, and then make the final cut. Then once they're assembled and glued, they're a near perfect match.